Welcome to CITAM Church Online. This is Pastor Karita Mbagara, the Deputy Bishop of Christ is the Answer Ministries, CITAM. Today I want us to talk about the secret to revival. I want to read from the book of Psalms, chapter 24, verse 3 and 4. Who may ascend the mountain of the Lord? Who may stand in his holy place? The one who has clean hands and a pure heart, who does not trust in an idol or swear by a false hand. This psalm is a secret to revival, and in fact, it caused a revival in Hebrides in the UK when 7 men and 2 women gave themselves to pray for revival. As they were praying, they didn't see much result until one day, one of them, as they were meeting, opened this psalm and read. And after reading, he challenged the people that were praying with him that unless we ourselves have clean hands and a pure heart, then we cannot expect God to show up. They started praying and they asked God to show them where their hands were not clean and where their hearts were not pure. And as they did this, a great visitation of God happened, and God started doing great things in their area. It is reported that people started falling under the power of God, even in other places where they were not present. 2 old women were given a vision of a vision in which many people had come to church. The person who writes about this, David Campbell, when he went to preach, he found one day the church packed and people were even outside the church. And what followed is that within 10 minutes of the service beginning, people were crying, seeking God. The point I want to make is this. For a long time, we've been praying for personal revival, but also revival in our churches and revival in our country. Could it be that the reason why we have not seen results to our praying is because we do not have clean hands and a pure heart? I take it that God is calling us to examine our hearts, to examine our acts, because clean hands talk about our conduct, our behavior, the things that we do. Can we say that they are right and before God, we have no condemnation? Because behind revival is purity of heart. It is good behavior or right behavior, godly conduct. It is that will bring the power of God down, because God does not delight in people who do not obey him. And my brothers and sisters, I want to urge you at a personal level to start examining yourself and asking yourself, in which ways are my hands not clean? What are some of the things that I do that are offensive to God? What are some of the thoughts that are in my heart that are offensive to God? And as you do that, ask the Lord even to point out the blind areas, the ones that you may not be aware, and then ask for revival. And we may just be surprised to see God visiting us in a fresh and a new way. May God help us to actually do that. And I believe that as we do that, we will see a mighty flow of the Spirit of God coming our way. God bless you. Let me hear what you think about what I have shared. You could also add to it through the social platforms that are listed here below. Thank you very much.